Hello and welcome to the One Stop Co-op Shop, your one stop for co-op news and playthroughs. And today I'm playing through Marvel Champions. There's 100 reasons I shouldn't be doing this stream tonight, but I'm doing it anyway. So the number one reason is I just planned this like 5 minutes ago. I'm like, you know what? I want to play some Marvel Champions tonight and let's do it. I haven't played through the campaign yet. I've only played the first mission. I played it like 4 times now, and I am playing the first mission to start the campaign tonight. I've only played Cyclops once, and I haven't even posted that video yet, so this will actually be your first chance seeing me play Cyclops. I threw this deck together literally just before I started streaming, like, again, 10 minutes ago. I threw this deck together. It's a leadership deck I wanted to try out, so it may be the deck I end up playing on Friday with the group. I'm not sure yet. So Mary, Terrence, and I are going to play through Mission 2, but this is Mission 1. So if you haven't seen Mission 1 yet, welcome. If you haven't done a solo playthrough or seen a solo playthrough, welcome for that as well. And if you want to see Cyclops, you'll definitely get to see Cyclops. Hopefully I don't mess it up too bad because I've literally only played him once and it was a while ago. All right. A while ago being like 4 days because it hasn't been out that long. It just feels like a while because there's so much that I've done over the last couple days. I don't think I've done this many videos in a long time. So if you want to see more Peter, you have got it this week. This is definitely... Oh, and the biggest reason I shouldn't be doing this right now is I have to work tomorrow, by the way. So I probably will only play through one mission tonight, but thanks for everybody who is joining out there. I saw quite a few people have joined already, which is amazing. I guess you all are in the same state as me, which is you just weren't ready to go to bed yet and not ready to get ready for work on Monday. All right, so let's start. We are in Washington, D.C. The mutant menace is a clear and present danger to these United States. Magneto and his Brotherhood have already attacked several mutant registration sites. That is why I support the Sentinel program. I'd like to show this Joker just how dangerous I am. Easy, comrade. We must be showing him humans and mutants can live together. Hey, meatbag. The Brotherhood is here for you. That maniac is going to kill him. Hurry, X-Men. You must rescue Senator Kelly. So, if you don't know, Sabretooth is attacking Senator Kelly. I am playing on standard, even though I constructed the deck. I'm really trying to get through the campaign quicker than I normally would. So I am playing the campaign, but so we got Frightened Police out. We got Senator Kelly. Basically, every round, we're going to add threat here as normal, but there's no loss condition here. The real loss condition is losing Senator Kelly. Right now, Senator Kelly has 0 damage on him, but he does have, let's put it this way, 9 life. So if Senator Kelly is ever killed, we lose the campaign, or lose the mission at least, and have to start over. But basically, once you remove all the threat from this scheme, then you win the campaign. Then you have Senator Kelly, then you got to get rid of, then it goes to more of a normal game. But our goal is to still kill Sabretooth. So now you got it. All right, so let's talk a little bit about Scott Summers or Cyclops. He is a leader. You may include X-Men allies from all aspects in your deck, which I have done. I don't think I've got all aspects, but I've got quite a few X-Men in here. And like I said, it is meant to be a leadership kind of ally deck. So it's constant training, action, search your deck for a tactic upgrade and add it to your hand. Limit once per round. So these tactic upgrades, you're going to be adding to villains, to minions, to different things like that. And they're kind of his big thing because on this side, he has an action attack. You can spend a resource of any type to deal 3 damage to an enemy with an upgrade attached. So you got to get these tactic upgrades out. This is interesting. Enemy with an upgrade attached. So I assume that means if they've got their own upgrade, that you could attack them as well. Interesting. So I did take the Peacekeeper role. Let's see what my card I get for that is. So in the campaign, you draw a random card at the beginning of the first mission. And then, like, if I beat this Peacekeeper mission here, then I get to draw a card for the second mission. And then there'll be a side scheme for the second mission. If I beat that, then I get to keep adding these cards at random. So it's a card. It's a one use. If you don't use it in this mission, it's gone for the rest of the campaign. So you may as well use it at some point. So you can spend 3 resources of any type to remove 5 threat from among schemes in play. Ready each ally you control. Remove this card from the game. Wow. So 3 resources to ready every ally and remove 5 threat. Seems not terrible. All right, so I got 6 card hand size on this side, 5 on this side, 10 hit points. That's all good. All right, let's go ahead and draw up. Ooh, lots of double resources. And I got Storm. Oh, and a power on all of us to keep Storm. And Danger Room Training. And Field Commander. So, you take the first turn. So, doesn't matter in solo at all, but the bottom part is the important part here. Each Cyclops upgrade attached to a minion loses its temporary keyword. So, normally, you're going to attach these... what are they called? I can't even think of the word. But you attach these things to the enemies, and once you attach them, then these upgrades. That's what they are, or these tactics. You attach them to minions, and they have temporary, and they go away. But now, they will not go away if you have this Field Commander, but only if they're attached to a minion, not if they're attached to the boss. Still pretty darn good card. Very good first turn card. Wow, I got a lot of stuff that I want to do on first turn. I kind of like everything in my hand. And I may just keep everything in my hand and search for a tactic that I don't care about. And then, that's probably what I'm going to do. All right, so I'm just going to keep my starting hand. Why not? So as an action, search for a tactic. All right, so let me do that. And by the way, if anybody has any experience with Cyclops or with the campaign, what do you think about it so far? Don't spoil too much for me, because honestly, I have not played past the first mission. So tactic, remove 3 threat from a scheme. Nah, I want one of these. Maybe. Choose a tactic in your discard pile and add it to your hand. So is this any tactic? Oh, upgrade tactic. So I can't do that anyway. So here's an upgrade one. Attached enemy gets -1 attack. I'm gonna use it to basically pay for something, so I want an upgrade that I don't really care about. This isn't a tactic, is it? No, it's training. Let's see. Upgrade tactic. Attached enemy is defeated. Draw 2 cards. You know what? That's good. I don't think there's too many minions in this, so I'm gonna draw this to my hand. So I'm not going to defeat him this turn, but I'm going to, like I said, I think I'm going to use it as a resource. So I want to get Storm out, reduce the cost by 1 if your identity has a mutant or X-Men trait. So I clearly do. We'll go ahead and spend power on all of us, and we will spend strength to put Storm out. There we go. My ally deck already has an ally turn 1. Then I'm going to do Field Commander. I'll just spend Genius for that and put Field Commander out. So now I am a Field Commander. Should probably shuffle this, by the way. Then I'm going to spend Priority Target to give Danger Room Training to Storm. What that does is your max 1 training per ally, but she gets +1 thwart, +1 attack, and +1 hit point. So 4 hit points, 3-3. All of that seems good. I am actually better at thwarting than I am at attacking. All right, so what do I do here? There's 5 threat here. I could actually remove it all just with Storm right now and just accelerate the heck out of this thing. Because it says, when Storm thwarts a scheme, move 2 threat from the scheme to another scheme. So I could literally thwart for 3 and then move 2 threat from here to the main scheme, which won't matter because this would go away then. I don't think I want to do that. That seems... It's very good, don't get me wrong. I only have attack of 1 and thwart of 2. So I'm going to thwart this for 2. Let's start with that. You know what? I'm going to use her to attack. Oh no, because that's the other annoying thing about Sabretooth, is after Sabretooth activates against you, discard the top card of the encounter deck, heal damage from Sabretooth equal to that number. You know what? 3 is still a decent amount of damage, though. I don't think Sabretooth's going to heal all 3 of it. I'm just going to start punching right away, turn 1. Let's do this. Let's get aggressive. And that is literally my turn 1. All right. So I am going to ready up. And I'm going to draw up. So I draw 5 cards on this side. Really like... Okay, so I got Professor X. Effective leadership. Which, when you spend this to play an ally, they get +1 thwart, +1 attack till the end of the phase. Seems good. After you play magic from your hand, spend a mental resource, choose a non-elite engage with an X-Men hero, and shuffle that minion into the encounter deck. Seems real good. Ricochet Beam, deal 3 damage to an enemy, 3 damage to an enemy with an upgrade attached to them. It's great if you have an upgrade attached to somebody. Thwart, remove 3 threat from a scheme. Wow, all right. So I got a lot of stuff here. I will probably be playing something this turn, some kind of ally or something like that. So what did I do? Oh, I did 3 damage. I did that. I readied up. We're good to go. Okay, so start by adding 1 threat here. If there is 6 per player, it increases the damage on Robert Kelly, but if not, you just do 2 damage to Robert Kelly, which is fine. Then Sabretooth is going to attack me. I'm just going to take that damage. So it's going to be 2 damage plus 1 for a total of 3 damage. 1, 2, 3. And then Sabretooth's going to heal based on the boost icons. 0 boost icons. Makes me very happy. Then I take my encounter card and let's see what happens. All right. So, one revealed hero, Sabretooth attacks you. If he has sustained no damage, he gets plus 1 attack. Well, guess what? He has sustained damage, so he doesn't add anything. Yeah, I'll just take it. So, 2 attack plus 0, which is good and bad, right? Because I'm a little bit scared of what's going to happen here with the healing, because we've drawn like 0 boost so far. Yep, there's 3. So, healed all the way to full. Remember that attack that Storm did? Yeah, all gone. Sabretooth, I don't know. The more I play against Sabretooth, the more I find him to be literally the most annoying first villain ever. Because you get all this stuff that's like, even without this campaign card, you get all this stuff that's like non-traditional for how you would normally play a game. And just trying to teach somebody to learn the game, if this was your first box you bought just because you were a huge X-Men fan, I think this would be too complicated to play, honestly, your first time. But maybe that's just me. Okay, so we could ready an X-Men character. What does this one do? Gets rid of a non-elite. I mean, I could just remove the 5 threat from here. I mean, it's like, it seems weird, but I mean, Storm could literally just do that, and it's better, obviously, than what you just did there. Deal 3 damage to the enemy, deal 3 damage. Now, the only positive is this scheme doesn't really hurt very much. It's really just the damage that's stacking up on Robert Kelly. So, I mean, I could just sit here. I mean, I could flip to Alter Ego here and not worry about it. I'd love to do Ricochet Beam when... Alright, so I can confuse, stun a minion, or ready an X-Men character at the end of the round. So, you know what? I'm just going to put magic in. And then we're just gonna start doing some damage. We're going to keep doing some damage. All right, so I'm going to spend 1. I don't care about removing threat. 2, 3. I'm actually going to hold on to Ricochet Beam. Like I said, I'm just going to worry about damage. He's plus 1 attack. Plus 1 thwart for this turn only. I'm not going to worry about paying anything else. So we're going to attack for 3, 6 over here. Seems not terrible. Hopefully he doesn't heal it all again. Because that makes me not happy when he heals all the damage I do. We're going to thwart for 2 over here, which gets rid of this frightened police. So in the midst of the chaos, the police have confused the X-Men with the enemy. When defeated, shuffle the top card of the Future Past deck. So I did put those. Here we go. Put this in here. So, gonna do that. Shuffle it into the encounter deck. Flip this card and put Metro PD into play. So this becomes a very large ally, but an ally nonetheless. We will make it a smaller ally to match with my other allies. Metro PD. Is a permanent. The first player controls the Metro PD. Exhaust them to choose to either deal a damage to an enemy or remove a threat from a scheme. Let us... and I did shuffle the Future Past card in. Yep, took care of that. Alright, so I've already thwarted. These two have already attacked. I do have Metro PD. You know what? We're doing one more. Everybody's shooting Sabretooth. We are done with you, Sabretooth. All right, so I'm going to hold on to Ricochet Beam, hoping I get an upgrade to attach to the enemy. All right, so I'm going to draw 4 cards. There you go. Practical defense. Attach enemy gets minus 1. Here's another thing for... Ooh, and I've got an ally. Angel. Reduce the cost to play Angel by 1 if your identity is Mutant or X-Men. So that means it is a two-cost ally, which is great. Temporary. Increase the amount of damage attached enemy takes from each attack by one, which is real good. Is this an attack? Deal one damage to an enemy or remove one threat from a scheme. You know what? That's not an attack. That is interesting, because that's actually way better than I thought for a scenario that I got going on upstairs. I'm playing with my wife right now. So when, what's her name's out? Mystique is out. You can't attack the boss. But that means the police could do damage. And you can still do retaliate damage. And I have attacks that are not attacks that just do damage. So yeah, I messed that up. And we should be killing that boss upstairs. So good to know. Because I was like, where do I get one more damage from? Well, now I know. That's not an attack. Now I know where to get it from. All right. Well, let's keep going. See, I'm learning something as we're playing as well. That's why I love doing these playthroughs. Just you just learn so much from it. And especially when people out in the chat are talking and they're very active and they tell me all the mistakes I made, or they tell me about mistakes they've made in gameplay. I love that kind of stuff. All right. So I'm getting attacked. This attack could theoretically kill me. So do I defend? Sure, I will defend. So I'll defend that attack. So that's plus two damage for a total of four, but I defend for two, so I only take two. Then he is going to heal for two, because I hate you, Sabretooth. I forgot. I also need to add two damage over here, Robert Kelly. Probably going down after this turn. What does this one do again? Oh, it readies my allies and removes a total of five threat. Yeah, that seems good. All right. And if I go down, then Robert Kelly's not going to get attacked next turn, which is good. So I got that going for me. All right. He'll get attacked if he stays here. He won't get attacked if he comes down. If I thwart out or I scheme this one out, which I might do. I haven't decided yet. All right. So he attacked me. So now let's go ahead and draw a card. The villain attacks you. Okay. So this is bad. As much as I like magic, I like myself more. So that's two damage plus another one. Attach card to a minion and give it the tough status. Well, there are no minions, so not going to happen. But that does do three damage, which is enough to kill magic. So magic, I appreciate what you've done for me. Unfortunately, now we're healing for two more, which is, God, that's annoying. All right. I don't know. That just really bothers me. Yeah, I should get over it. I know. I should definitely get over it. All right. Well, let's go ahead and giving the enemy minus one attacks, not really that useful. Kind of want to defeat him. Is this an attack? No, it's just deal three damage to an enemy with an upgrade attached. So that's not an attack either. Oh, it is an attack. Action attack. So that would be an attack. So I'd like to put Angel in. Let's do that. All right, so Angel costs two. So let's pay one for sure. And Ricochet Beam's just not going to happen. So that's two. So Angel gets put in with plus one to both their stats for this turn. Then, I mean, I guess I got to put the free upgrade on, which gives him minus one attack. But I'm going to do that so I can Laser Beam here. All right, so spend one resource of any type, deal three damage to an enemy with an upgrade attached. Boom, boom, boom. Three damage. One, two, three. And then we're going to have Angel attack for another three damage. One, two, three. Oh, both of them get plus one to their damage because I lied. I didn't put that upgrade on. Just kidding. Just kidding. All right. Do I want Robert Kelly to take more damage, or do I just beat the main scheme right now? She isn't going to live much longer, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's beat the main scheme. All right, so she is going to go ahead and thwart, which will take three off of here. Then we're going to take the other two and put it on the main scheme. When defeated, the first player detaches Robert Kelly from the scheme and and takes control of him. Advance the main scheme to 2A. All right, so I got Robert Kelly in my control now. So first player controls Robert Kelly. He doesn't count against your ally limit and cannot have player cards attached. When the enemy resolves an undefended attack against you, deal that damage to Robert Kelly. So basically now we just have to keep defending for Robert Kelly. All right, so this goes away and turns into this, which is Robert Kelly cannot be healed by player cards or effects. Hero response, after your hero defends an attack from Sabretooth, spend two resources of any type to ready your hero. Only the player who controls Robert Kelly can trigger this ability. Let me make sure I understand this. When an enemy resolves an undefended attack against you, any enemy, so that does include minions. So I have been playing that right. All right, this scheme does go away. After the villain resolves step one of the villain phase, deal two damage. While Robert Kelly is attached, find the senator. Where does it say that? I know it says somewhere. When defeated, the first player detaches Robert Kelly and takes control of him. Advance the main scheme 2A, flip this card. All right. So, when revealed, deal each player a face down encounter card. That's not wonderful. Should have remembered that. Let's flip it over. This takes 9, and it doesn't have anything on it right now. So, we got that going for us at least. When defeated, defeat Robert Kelly. If Robert Kelly leaves play, the players lose the game. Now, the question is, do I flip down? I mean, I feel like I have to. And then I can even start using, you know, my get a tactics card thing. So, yeah, I'll go ahead and flip down. That'll let me get a tactics card plus draw an extra card. I just hope I don't lose to threat here. That would stink. 9 threat on one turn. I mean, it's possible. You know, both advances are still in there. All right, so I am going to ready up. I'm going to draw up. So I get 6 cards. Ooh, danger room. After an X-Men alter ego response, after an X-Men ally enters play, exhaust it to search your deck and discard pile for a training upgrade and attach it to an ally. Any player whose alter ego has a mutant trait may trigger this ability. So, yep, we get to put a free training on. R&D facility, exhaust R&D facility to remove a counter from it. Choose a friendly character in play. They get plus one thwart and attack till the end of the phase. All right. So I only have one of those in there. I kind of threw it in. I haven't played with it before. Tactical Brilliance. Remove 3 threat from a scheme. Choose a tactic card in your discard pile and add it to your hand. Nice. Beast. After Beast enters play, search your deck and discard pile for a resource card and add it to your hand so you can grab a double resource. Super sweet. Again, Practical Defense. And Team Building. There we go. Play a card from your hand that shares a trait with your hero. Yes, please. For X-Men. Because I actually have 2 of those in my deck. So I know you can only play one at a time or use one at a time. But if I want to play multiple allies on a turn, plus I want to try to get it earlier, which, I mean, I guess I'm still... Nah, I'm barely past the top half of my deck. But yeah, I wanted to get it early enough. But anyway, what are you going to do? All right, so there's one attack. He is going to scheme for 1. So let's go ahead and... There goes Pyro, that's good. So a total of 3. And then he's going to heal after that for 1. He doesn't heal for the star icons, only the boost icons, which is good. And then I'm going to take a second card. All right. Shuffle this into your deck. So these cards are interesting. These are from, what's her name? Mystique's encounter set. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. And then... So they pop up and do bad stuff to you. We've seen that before, but I find it interesting here. Ah, when defeated, Sabretooth attacks the player who defeated the scheme, even if the player is in alter ego form. Well, that's wonderful. More attacks against me. You know what I wanted? More attacks against me. By the way, what I didn't want? More attacks against me. But that is 2 cards, so not too bad. It's not bad, although an advance could lose me the game, so I kind of hate that. I am going to try to focus on attacking, so we'll see. We'll see how this goes. All right, so first thing I can do is search your deck for a tactics upgrade. So let's go ahead and do that and see what we can get. Why don't I have my visor yet? Who knows? Priority target. Oh, you know what I want? I want the one that... that doesn't make you take consequential damage. If I have it still. If not, I might take priority target. When they're defeated, draw 2 cards. That's pretty darn good, too. Increase the amount of damage they take by 1. I mean, it's very good, don't get me wrong, but when you're trying to kill him, it's very good. I don't know about right now. Okay, you know what? I am taking the when they're defeated, draw two cards one. This one is kind of cool. Oh, so this goes away, by the way. At the end of the round, these are discarded, so they don't have minus one attack anymore. Actually, you would add minus one attack there. Oh, but I was flipped anyway, so never mind. All right, so when they're defeated, draw two cards. And when you defeat a phase or stage of them, that does count as them being defeated. Could give them minus one attack as well. I like the draw two cards right now. Let's see. Spend three resources of any type. Remove five threat. It's kind of good. And it lets me ready all my guys too. But the problem is that, like, Storm's almost dead over here. So she only has one hit point left. Yeah, R&D facility is good, but I think I'm going to do Danger Room. Can I do Danger Room and Beast? Well, I can if I defeat him while I am Alter Ego. All right, so I'm going to attack for three. One, two, three. Which sadly gets rid of Storm. And then I'm going to attack for two. He attacked for three last time because I played that resource to make him better. So we're going to advance the stage. He now has the tough status card. Oh! I could have attacked with my optical. No, but I can't because I couldn't flip. All right, so he's now tough. But I did defeat him, so I do draw two cards. Seems good. Oh, no. Oh, whoa. I did not shuffle because that was the second card when I was looking through my deck. Now, to be fair, it could be there anyway. I'm going to shuffle five times. One, two, three, four, five. I remember it being the second one. I'm like, oh, thank goodness I'm shuffling. All right. So you can call that a cheat if you want. I don't call it a cheat because, honestly, I was literally, I saw it up there and I knew I couldn't. So anyway. All right. So I'm drawing two or paying two to put Danger Room in, which will allow me to, when I put Beast in, make it better. Okay. Two for team building exercise does not give me enough to build Beast. So I'm just going to pay for it. One. Two. Three. Four for Beast. Oops. Wait, why am I holding on to this like I care? Would I rather hold on to something else? Oh, because I'm going to get a resource of my choice. So yeah, I'm going to hold on to team building exercise instead. So after Beast Center plays, search your deck and discard pile for a resource. Yep. So here we go. This is a resource, energy. And then I will put in team building exercise. There we go. Also, because I'm on Alter Ego, I'm going to exhaust this. Search your deck and discard pile for a training upgrade and attach it to that ally. All right. So that training upgrade that just went away, Danger Room training. Now Beast has plus one attack or plus one thwart and whatchamacallit and an extra life. Which seems good. Okay, I'm gonna heal. I'm gonna recover for three. I'm gonna flip over. Don't have three resources for that. So I could get rid of this, but then Beast would just attack me right now, which I'm not real happy about. So I'm gonna have the Metro PD attack and get rid of this tough. And I am going to attack with Beast for three. I think I do. Why not? One, two, three. I'll count on not overhealing. Seems like a reasonable thing, right? Not overhealing? Why not? Still haven't done this. Five threat and ready each ally you control. Seems not terrible. Oh, wait, why is R&D there? No one knows. Okay, all right, so I'm going to ready up. I am going to draw up Wolverine. Wolverine's so fun. So they do, Wolverine attacks for 3. He does take 2 consequential damage, but he heals 1 at the beginning of every turn. And he has 4 life. So, so fun. Ooh, I finally got rapid response. That is also good. Ah, X-Mansion. So alter ego action, exhaust X-Mansion, heal 1 damage from a mutant or X-Men character. Any player whose alter ego has a mutant trait may trigger this. So it might be in front of me, but anybody I'm playing with can trigger it. The other cool part about it is it can heal allies, which is freaking awesome. Optical Blast. You know what I don't have? A Tactics, which is a little sad. Exhaust S-Check to generate a resource for any X-Men character, which is also kind of cool. But the negative is I can't do it when I'm on my alter ego because I'm a mutant there, not an X-Men. All right. So we are going to add 1 threat to the scheme. Then Sabretooth is going to attack me. I'm going to block with Angel over here because Angel just has 1 life left. So Angel takes 3 damage and is defeated. Then Sabretooth heals 4-0. Hey, and it gets rid of an advance. That is like double plus good right there. Holy crap. I like it. I like it. All right, so last thing, I take my encounter card and give to the Scott Summers player. Hey, that's me. Search your hand, deck, and discard pile for the Ruby Quartz visor and place it face down under this card. So it gets rid of your visor, but guess what? I have not gotten my visor yet anyway, so it doesn't matter. And yes, I will shuffle after I search through here. Oh, it was my next card, literally. Shuffle. Oh, wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, so Cyclops cannot attack at all, period. Alter ego action. Exhaust Scott Summers, add Ruby Quartz visor to your hand, and remove the lost visor from the game. Alright. Well, that's kind of cool. First of all, it lets me get my visor. The visor lets you generate a free resource for this Optic Blast ability, which costs a resource normally. So the nice part is it's a free resource to do this as long as you have a tactic to put on the enemy. So guess what? I am flipping down next turn because I want to get my visor, which seems good. Okay, but for this turn, I won't attack. That's fine. I can thwart. So that was the card I drew, and so back to my turn. By the way, it's awful quiet out there. So anybody, please feel free to chime in and talk about your experiences or anything you want to talk about, honestly. I'm pretty open. Exhaust the mansion to heal 1 damage. I am going to be on alter ego, so that would be kind of nice. But this is going to cost 4. 1, 2, 3. So which of these do I care more about? Probably the free resource for the rest of the game, right? So I'll put the mansion out. So that'll be 4 to put Wolverine in, which is always good. So that was last turn. So this gets discarded. So the end of the enemy phase, that gets discarded. All right. So I'm going to thwart for 2 because I can't attack because of this. Although, who cares about that? I mean, I probably should, but whatever. Oh, I know why I care about that, because this is very bad. Huh. Maybe I just don't attack for the rest of the game. All right. Let's get rid of this for 2. Spending 3 resources to get rid of 5, that is probably what I should do next turn. Okay. All right. So I'm going to do that, and then Beast is going to attack for 3. Now it's 2 damage on him, although he still has 2 life left. So 1, 2, 3. Then Wolverine is going to get 2 damage on him. Attack for 3. 1, 2, 3. Police Force can do 1 damage. I mean, I win next turn if I just live through this, it looks like. So I just can't lose to threat here. Which I could spend the three, would be nice, but training upgrade, attach it to that ally. Yeah, so had I been alter ego, I could have done that and given him that training upgrade, which would have been one more damage, but it's fine. All right, so I'm going to ready up. I'm going to draw up. Do I keep this resource generator? I mean, it's the end of the game, right? No way. I just draw and get the best cards I can. Cyclops, pretty good. Another team building. Oh, I did get this. All right, so now I do have to, after this card enters your hand, discard an ally or support you control. You may discard this card from your hand at the end. Ah, sorry. Wow. Okay, so I gotta discard an ally or support I control, and then this card gets discarded to the thing. Okay, so ally or support. Well, that's an upgrade. You know what? Buy danger room. I'm gonna keep my allies. Yep, we're good. Okay. And then technically that's in my hand until the end of my turn, but whatevs. All right. So I guess I could randomly discard it if something tells me to randomly discard something, but I'm not gonna worry about that right now. All right. So Sabretooth attacks me. Beast is going to block, defend for me. Actually, do I want to do that, or do I just want to defend myself since I can't attack? I'm going to defend myself. So I defend for 2, attacks me for 2, plus 2 is 4. So I take 2 damage above and beyond. Sabretooth is going to heal for nothing because that's a star, not a boost. The king. First time chatter, I'm really enjoying your gameplay. Thanks, King. I appreciate it. And welcome. Yeah, you should join us Friday night. There is a lot of cool chatter that happens. We always appreciate it when people talk, because otherwise it kind of feels like I'm here by myself, which, I mean, honestly, I was going to play this game by myself anyway tonight, so it's fine. Sabretooth attacks you. If you sustain no damage, plus 1 attack. All right, so here's the question. Can I survive this? Not really. All right, so Beast is going to take this. That's all right. I got Colossus in my hand to hopefully finish him off. All right. So, Beast is taking this attack. Attach this card to a minion. There are no minions, so he attacks for 3. And Beast blocks all 3 of that and goes away. Sorry, Beast. That's okay. Okay, so the healing is the important thing here. No healing. Yes! Yes, yes! All right. Wow. All right, I am getting super lucky with that healing, but I am not going to complain, and I'm not going to talk about it anymore because, well, it's over. So Cyclops cannot attack. All right, I'm good. So let's get Colossus in, shall we? So I'm going to spend team building exercise. Well, so hold on. Kind of dumb, but I'm doing it anyway just to show. All right, I'm flipping over. I am going to play Colossus. Oh, I don't share a trait with him anymore. Ah, so this is anti-synergy here because this I have to share a trait, and Colossus is X-Men traded, whereas this card over here, not this card. Oh, it's gone anyway. I got rid of it. Ha ha, sucker. But it would have let me put Danger Room training, this Danger Room over here, after an X-Men ally enters play. It's a little anti-synergy with team building, though, I'm realizing now, because I can only do team building when I'm up, and I can only use Danger Room when I'm face down. So, yeah, so that's an issue. All right, but anyway, 1, 2, 3, 4 to put Colossus in. Colossus comes in tough, so got that going for him. Usually I wouldn't knock off the tough, but, I mean, come on. Oh, that's the other thing. They trigger a lot of stuff at the beginning of your turn now and the end of the enemy's turn. Like, I'd remove all the tactics cards at the end of the enemy turn. And then response after your turn begins, heal a damage from Wolverine. So there's a little bit of weirdness with when stuff triggers now, because it used to be very straight up and obvious. But anyway, all right. Frightened Police do 1 damage. Wolverine does 3 damage. Colossus does 3 damage. That's a total of 7. Boom, boom, boom. Victory. So King says, I'll try to keep that in mind. My group tends to play this or Marvel United on Fridays. Do you have any thoughts on the final two X-Men heroes that haven't been announced yet? Okay, so I am not a big one for spoilers. But I guess if you were talking about making guesses on stuff that haven't been announced yet, then I have no problem making guesses. Honestly, it's funny. I said one of my favorite heroes was Phoenix, and I was hoping she'd make it, not realizing that she was going to be one of the ones that came out when this set came out. Do I start setting up the next mission? You know what? I'll start setting up just for fun while we're talking here. Yeah, so who would I like to see? I'd love to see Nightcrawler. I mean, Nightcrawler, I feel like, is a favorite. Gambit, I think, is another favorite for people. As far as heroes go. Just because, I mean, it's cool, right? He's a card throwing, like, whatever. I mean, that's just fun. So, yeah, I mean, if I was to pick two exactly, those would be the two I'd pick. Nightcrawler and Gambit. Some other ones. I mean, Professor X would be kind of fun to see as a hero, right? Like, I don't know. That'd be fun. I doubt they'd do this, but what about Magneto? I wouldn't mind using Magneto as a hero. Oh, by the way, I just did not save any of that stuff. So, yeah. So I'm going to have to do this again. I'm an idiot. So Cyclops. I was a Peacekeeper. Which card did I have the first time? Because I can't have it again. Mentorship was my first card, so I can't have that again. So let me put that down. Mentorship. I did not get a future past card removed. I did beat that in scenario one, though, and now I'm at Peacekeeper. Life doesn't matter because I'm not playing expert. So apparently, I am. All right. So let's read at least through the next thing, and we'll see. We'll see if I decide to play or not. So victory. If the Frightened Police side scheme was defeated, record it in the campaign log. I did that. Remove each future pass card in the victory display from the campaign. Didn't have any. Add each future pass card found in the encounter deck, discard pile, and in play to the campaign log. So I should add one. Since I don't know what it was, and it doesn't matter because I never even saw it, we'll do place modulars, and I will grab future past. I will shuffle it up, and I will flip one up at random because, honestly, that's basically what happened. So, Nimrod. There's literally somebody called Nimrod. I mean, not an easy Nimrod, but a Nimrod nonetheless. All right, Nimrod. Sorry, that makes me laugh a little bit. Oh. Future past cards in the victory display. No, he was not in the victory display. I never saw Nimrod last game. Nimrod. All right, that makes me happy. King, I see you talking out there. I will be with you in 1 minute as I get through, after I'm done getting through what I'm supposed to do here. Oh, that's right. Okay, so each player chooses... we did this. All right, victory. Remove each role upgrade that began the game in play in the campaign. Yep, did that. Okay. So, I will get to the story, but let me respond to whatever the King's got going on over there, because I do like to be responsive, because I think that is the way streams should be, because otherwise, why are we here live? Okay. So, mentorship is gone from the campaign. I need to delete it. Honestly. Okay. Guesses. Who would you want? Gambit would be mine. Iceman could be interesting. Yeah, I think so too. I mean, there would just be a lot of stunning though, right? Maybe confusing. He could be fun though. I mean, look, I don't mind a very stun heavy hero. That would be fun. Or you have Freeze, which works a lot like a Spider-Man card where all webbed up, where it takes them a couple turns to get out of it. They could do an interesting mechanic with Bishop and some kind of special retaliate. Okay, I don't know enough about Bishop. This is where my... I did used to watch the cartoon a lot when I was a kid, but that was years ago. And I've seen the movies, but Bishop's not really featured in any of the movies. So, I don't know. All right, so let's continue on with the campaign, at least reading it, and then we'll see if I play anymore. I shouldn't. It's 1 in the morning here, and I got to work tomorrow. But that doesn't mean I won't, because I've never played past Mission 1. Here, Senator, are you okay? You get your hands off me, mutant. I had enough of your help. That girl just saved your life. I ought to rip your head off. Oh, that's Wolverine. Wolverine, no! Driver, get me out of here. Hello, Gyrich? It's Robert. We can't wait for Congress anymore. It's time to launch Project Wide Awake. Dun dun dun. I understand, Senator. I'll deploy the Sentinels immediately. What? No. Not sent. I just saved you. You dog. All right. So, I'm going to read the setup at least and we'll see. Excuse me. Even though the X-Men rescued Robert Kelly from Sabretooth's attack, the Senator's prejudice against mutants is only intensified by the attempt on his life. He contacts Henry Gyrich, head of the top secret commission on Project Wide Awake, to discuss their response to the escalating conflict. The two men agreed that the mutant menace is out of control and they can no longer afford to wait for the legislation to pass. They need to activate the Sentinels immediately. Later that night, mutant hunting robots deploy across the United States. Utilizing their sophisticated scanners, the Sentinels begin hunting down unsuspecting mutants. The surge in psionic energy caused by these mutants' primal terror alerts Professor X to their plight. Using his telepathy, he directs the X-Men to stop the Sentinels and rescue as many of the captured mutants as they can. All right, so we are going to be rescuing mutants and the villains, Sentinel 1 and 2. Okay, main scheme. All right, encounter deck, Project Wide Awake. I mean, it should tell me that, right? So let's go ahead and do this. All right, Project Wide Awake. Standard. Recall that. Place the modulars. Sentinels. All right. Project Wide Awake. Zero tolerance and standards. Oh, and Sentinels. Wide Awake. Wait, Wide Awake is this mission. All right, so zero tolerance and Sentinels. Zero tolerance and Sentinels. So that's Sentinels, and that's zero tolerance, and of course I need to place the standard. They do have like more thematic cards here. I really appreciate that, but I like seeing the normal ones come up. All right, so let's make sure that that is what it says here too. Main deck, Knight of Sentinels, Project Wide Awake, Sentinels, Zero Tolerance, standard sets. The standard set can be found, we got it. Sentinels can be, set can be removed and added to other scenarios. Yeah, we got all that. All right. Operation Zero Tolerance. Project Wide Awake tells the story of Sentinels capturing mutants and rounding them up intermittent. To bring the story to life, the setup instructions on the main scheme 1A have players put the Operation Zero Tolerance 104 side scheme into play. This side scheme introduces an alternative loss condition for the players to avoid. It reads, Force Response. I mean, we'll read it in a minute, right? Main scheme also gives Zero Tolerance the permanent keyword, so it cannot leave play during the scenario. That means the players will need to defeat the Sentinel's villain before too many cards are placed under Operation Zero Tolerance. Oh, this might be very bad for allies, which an ally deck might be really bad. Players who wish to modify difficulty, I do not. All right. So we haven't gotten to setup yet. Here we go. Shuffle each future pass card recorded in the campaign long into the encounter deck. Shuffle the remaining cards from future pass deck and set them aside. So Nimrod is going in. This I can delete too. This is the police one, right? Yep. All right. So where's Nimrod? There's Nimrod. Nimrod's going in. Oh, I guess I should put my obligation in as well. And then I'll put my set aside stuff over here. By the way, King says, as far as Bishop goes, he can absorb some blasts and then shoot them out of his hands, but also has a huge gun. I just know of him from the animated series. Okay. I mean, that's pretty neat. Like, I like the ability to absorb stuff. Oh, he was in the latest Deadpool, I think, wasn't he? He was part of the X-Force or whatever. From the latest Deadpool, from Deadpool 2. I believe that is true. Could be wrong, though. All right. If Frightened Police was defeated, check the campaign log. Each player takes one random upgrade from their role set of cards and puts it into play under their control. Each player may role build. So role building, the way that works is you could take stuff from the roles that are affiliated. So for example, Peacekeeper is affiliated with leadership and justice. So I could add one leadership and one justice card to my deck. Now, to be honest, I'm already a leadership deck, so why would I do that? But you could actually take, you know, I could be aggression and be a Peacekeeper and take those cards. So it's kind of fun. It gives you more options for deck building. I think that's how it works. I haven't done it yet, but I'm not going to. Maybe when we play with our normal Friday night, I will, because we're playing expert campaign. So, I mean, whenever you're doing expert, you know, I don't have a problem with doing stuff, whatever you can to help yourself. Reveal the enemy of my enemy side scheme. All right. So there we go. We will reveal that. All right. Magneto also fights the Project Vulnerable Mutants from to protect vulnerable mutants from Sentinels. Oh, thank you, Magneto. I appreciate your help. When defeated, shuffle the top card of the future pass deck into the encounter deck, flip this card, and put Magneto into play under the first player's control. Oh yeah, we are definitely getting Magneto in as soon as humanly possible. Alright, so what does this say here, and what are these cards here? When defeated, the first player searches the encounter deck and discard pile for a Sentinel minion and reveals it. Flip this card to the and put Jubilee into play, discarding any other version of Jubilee from play. Huh. Okay. So, toughness. When revealed, the first player searches the encounter deck and discard pile for a copy of Abduction Protocol side scheme and reveals it. That's Mutants in the Mall. So, I need to search for ABD, Abduction Protocols. Put it into play. I guess if you were doing stage two, you wouldn't do that, but all right. Hinder 2, victory. So there is victory on this, which means, oh, 2 means 2 per player. Victory means it's going to go in the victory display after this is done. When defeated, the player who defeated the scheme takes one random set aside captive. Oh, nice. Ally and puts it into play under their control. So this is very similar to, I forget who else does this, but there's another one in one of the campaigns where you're rescuing allies as well, which is awesome. Okay, but this starts with this in play, which means lets you get it out earlier. All right. Setup. Set each captive ally aside. Reveal the Operation Zero Tolerance and Mutants in the Mall. Operation Zero Tolerance. Is that the other side of this? Nope. So search for Operation Zero Tolerance. Okay, here we go. Wow, that is a lot of side schemes. By the way, Force Response. So which one has permanent? I thought they said one of these had permanent in it. We'll see. Might be this one. So we'll start with 3 on here. After the enemy attacks and defeats an ally, place that ally face down under the scheme. This is the one. If there are X face down cards under the scheme, the players lose the game. X is 3 more than the number of players. So you can't chump, is really what it's saying. Where did it say something was permanent? Didn't it say something was permanent? Project Wide Awake tells the story of the Sentinels capturing. Force response after an enemy is defeated. Place them under... All right. Main Scheme 1B also gives Operation Zero Time in the permanent keyword. Ah, we haven't gotten there yet. That's why. That's what's going on here. Operation Zero Tolerance gets permanent. All right. So there you go. Ah, so we start with 1 on here and accelerates 1 per turn. After threat is placed here, if there is at least 5 per player threat here, the first player places the top card of their deck face down under zero tolerance, then removes 5 threat from this scheme. So, whenever there's 5 per player on here, you don't lose, but you're going to add 1 to here. Once there are 4 cards here, you do lose. Interesting. Oh, and you're giving you allies too. Like, just in case you don't have a lot of allies, which I do. So, but apparently I'm not chumping with my allies this game. That is what I learned from reading. Reading is fundamental. You know what? I am playing one more scenario. I'm going to play Sentinels. I just want to. That's all. I shouldn't be. I need to work tomorrow, but that's fine. All right, let's do it. And what's this? After you recover, deal 3 damage from among characters you control and draw a card. Well, that'll let my allies stay and play longer. Remove this card from the game and the campaign pool. All right, so let's go ahead and let's make sure I shuffled. Draw 6 cards. Danger Room. Well, there you go. Oh, and I got a double resource to play it. Of course, I also have a double resource to play. Oh, man. All right, so I got a lot of good stuff. I think I'm just holding again, like last game. And I'm going to search for an upgrade that I don't care about. The one that lets me draw 2 cards. Let's look, search for a 0 cost card. I know there's one in here. I should just learn the name of it. So turn 1, when I want to use it as a resource, I can do that. Although there are going to be allies. Priority target? Yes. Priority target. All right, I'm going to draw it. Again, I'm not mulliganing, which is weird, right? Like, normally people mulligan, but I am not mulliganing. Okay. So, I'm going to spend a double resource for team building. Oh, no, no, no. Now that I think about it, because I have team building... So wait, if I do Danger Room instead for with this double resource. Yeah, no, I won't have enough. So double resource, 1. Yeah, so actually, I'm not going to get team building. Let's search for one that I should care about, but I need one that's 0 cost. Because we'll do the one that reduces his attack by 1, whatever that one's called. That is also 0 cost. Nope, that is also team building. I don't want that. 0, 0, 0, there it is. -1 attack. We'll do that instead. And then, since I look through, what is going on here? Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. All right. So, I am going, well, if I flip, all right, let's flip. Team building 1, 2, 3, 4 gives Colossus +1 to both of his stats this turn. He starts with tough, but that's not going to last long. I know I should probably just chump with him, but I got +1 to my stats this turn. Can give the enemy -1 attack. There's a lot of threat out here. I kind of wish I had a different ally. I mean, I could get rid of this acceleration this turn, which would give me Magneto right away. You know, not Magneto. Yeah, Magneto. Yeah, so I'll do that. I'll thwart for 2 here. 1, 2. Yeah, I don't want to add a minion, but I also don't want 2 acceleration here right off the beginning. So Colossus also has 2. So I guess that didn't really matter. That's fine. We'll remove this. Shuffle the top card of the future past. I will just already check this off, by the way, that I defeated it. Where's the future past? Shuffle this one in. Into here. Do not keep it on top, so there are two future past cards in there. And now I'm going to get Magneto. Who knows what Magneto does? Somebody does, but that somebody is not me. All right, so I rescued Magneto, who is a 2-3. Not going to complain about that. One victory. The first player controls Magneto. So I guess when he's defeated, he goes to the victory display. He does not count against your ally limit. Response after Magneto attacks and defeats a Sentinel minion. Heal one damage from Magneto. Sweet. So do I thwart for two here just to start working on this as well? Or maybe start working on this. Maybe I do that so I can start removing threat from the main scheme. Yeah, let's do that. So Magneto is going to thwart for two. Colossus didn't take damage because he was... all right. And then I could thwart that for two next turn, and then we could start working on this other stuff. All right. Well, that's not terrible. Turn one, got to be honest. Does not make me sad that that is my turn one. All right. So, I'm not done. Oh, no. Lest you think I forgot about my Optical Blast, which I did, totally. Spend one resource of any type. Well, here you go, Danger Room. Like I said, that's an anti-synergy card. But he's got... It's not piercing, is it? Please be piercing. Three damage to an enemy with an upgrade. No. All right. So, not piercing. Excuse me. Not piercing, but does get rid of tough, which is a thing. All right. So, minus one attack to this Sentinel. Let's go ahead and ready up and draw up. Ah, here you go. Attach enemy is defeated. Draw two cards. Wow. I really want to attach. Oh, X-Jet, though. Free resources. And I got Angel. Yeah, there's a lot of good stuff. Okay. So, first things first, we're going to add a threat here. Plus one for mutants in the mayhem, whatever. All right, so we're attacking. Minus one attack, so I will defend, because why not? So he's attacking for one. Star, put Sentinel Mark 4 into play, engage with you. Okay. Guard patrol, while this minion is engaged with you, you cannot thwart the main scheme. Well, yes, that's what patrol means. Ah, I guess they're explaining it. Okay, so I just took some damage. But I didn't take some damage. I took zero damage because, one, this isn't boosted for anything. I defend for two, so I'm good. But I'm going to take two damage here. One, two. Ah, I don't have to heal him. Oh, that feels so good not to heal him after every attack. This seems more fun already, by the way, than that first mission. I don't know. That it does start with a lot of stuff in play, but I don't know. It seems like a super fun mission already. Okay. So, I am done with all of this stuff, and now I draw an encounter card. Oops. Attached to the villain. It's a gauntlet beam. The villain's attacks gains piercing and range. So piercing gets rid of tough, range gets ignores retaliate. I don't care about either of those things, because I don't think I have a way to get tough in here, and I don't really have retaliate. So, yeah, I'm just going to leave that on him. Wait, that's an attachment, not an upgrade, right? Let me see. Spend one resource, deal three damage to an enemy with an upgrade, not an attachment. All right, so this is an attachment. Good to know. I was like, oh, that's broken, but it's not really broken. Okay, well, I have some ideas, and all of them are good. Probably not. Okay, first things first, I am going to attach priority target. Oh, well, first things first, this gets discarded at the end of the enemy phase. So then I'm going to attach this priority target over here. When I defeated, I get to draw some cards, which seems good. Attacks for three. What does it say? After Magneto attacks and defeats a Sentinel, heal one damage from Magneto. So, I mean, I could have him kill him. All right. So do I discard? Yeah, I'll discard this priority target to do my optical beam. So that's three damage on the Sentinel. Magneto will kill him and heal that one damage that he just took. Priority target says that I get to draw two cards if I defeat a minion. All that seems good. By the way, in case you were wondering if that was good or bad, why did I exhaust the Sentinel? No one knows. All right, so all that seems good. I just drew two cards, effective leadership and tactical brilliance. Remove three threat from a scheme. Choose a tactic card in your discard pile and add it to your hand. Yes, I'd like to do that. Okay, so we are going to do that. So I'm going to spend two for tactical brilliance. Again, remove three threat and take a tactic card. I'm going to take this tactic card right off the top. So we will remove three threat from scheme. Boom, boom. Gets rid of this. The player who defeated the scheme takes a random captive and puts it into play under their control. All right. So another ally. Now, Magneto doesn't count as an ally. Wolfsbane attacks gain piercing and does look... Oh, wish you had tough now, buddy. And then I believe the only way that a card comes here is if the enemy attacks and defeats him. After an enemy attacks and defeats an ally. So they can die of natural causes or from, like, you know, whatever it's called, from getting too much... damage on them from whatchamacallit damage. Why can't I think right now? I can't think what the name of that damage is. Consequential damage. That's what it is. So if they get consequential damage, then it's fine. But if they die for, they don't want you to chump, basically, is what they're telling you. All right. I would love to get X-Jet into play. Is it possible? X-Jet isn't X-Men. I can do it, but then I couldn't get Angel into play. I think that's a sacrifice I'm willing to make for sure. All right, so it's one. Two. Three. To get X-Jet into play. X-Jet, exhaust it. Generate a resource for an X-Men. So I can't do it when I'm on my other side, but I can use it on this side. So these two together would let me get Angel in, but unfortunately I had to use team building. It's fine. I'm gonna hold on to Angel. Still seems worth it. Colossus, I am gonna have attack. He's gonna take two consequential damage because he's got the two stars under him. So that is three damage. One, two, three. And then Wolfsbane will also attack. He takes one consequential damage. But does two damage. All right, I got some allies. So for a mission that's telling you don't have allies, actually it's not really telling you that. It's just saying don't let them die from getting attacked. And it's not even telling you that because you can have up to three cards here. So I don't know. There's some wiggle room there. All right, I'm going to ready up. I am going to keep Angel. I'm going to draw four other cards though and keep going. Ooh, R&D facility, X-Mansion, alter ego. Heal damage from a mutant or X-Men character. Professor X. Okay, but Professor X is great if you're flipping down because you can confuse. So that might not be the worst thing ever. And thwarts for three? Yeah, maybe. That might be what happens. All right, but sadly, we are ending two here, which gets it to five. The first player places the top card of their deck face down under Operation Zero Tolerance. Yeah, I didn't really pay attention to that. So hopefully that's not like my visor. Let's see. All right, Field Commander, not as bad, but still pretty bad. So that was an error on my part. I wasn't paying attention to the acceleration there, and that got me. All right, so he is going to attack me for two. I will defend again. So two plus one is three. So I will take one damage. I keep wanting to heal him afterward. Like, I don't have to do that. Rich plays board games. Hello. Says hello from Germany. Hello, Rich. I've heard of your channel before. I haven't had a chance to watch it because, let's be honest, I've streamed like 90 times over the last day. But that's not the only reason. That's not a good excuse. I should definitely check you out at some point. But welcome. And our audience, check out Rich Plays Board Games. All right, so, where was I at? He just attacked me, so now I have to take an encounter card. I don't want to go back. No, don't do that. Please don't. Please don't. No. It always ends up messing something up when you do that. So hopefully not. Okay. All right. So this is my encounter card. It is a tough Mark III Sentinel. Awesome. I have someone with piercing, which makes me happy. When revealed, search the encounter deck and discard pile for an energy barrier attachment and attach it to this minion. Well, okay. I will do that. Yeah, see, it always messes up something. All right, so search for energy barrier. I will get that. I will shuffle. Okay. What does this do? Attach a sentinel minion without an energy barrier attached. Give it a tough status. Otherwise, this card gains surge. I don't think this card would gain surge, right? Attach it to a minion without an energy barrier and give it tough status. Otherwise, it gains surge. I think if you can attach it, it would gain surge. Force response. After attaching a minion attacks, give it a tough status. And it's got plus 2 attack. Oh my gosh. So 5 attack. And it's tough. It only has 3 life though. And I have piercing here. So that's not the worst thing ever. So, okay. I was a little scared for a second, but I'm not as scared. I'm not scared now. All right. Well, I do need to do... I need to get rid of this acceleration. Put Jubilee for Sentinel minion and reveal it. Yeah. That other Sentinel wasn't too bad. So maybe I get that one back. We'll see. Okay. So we're going to attack for 2. With piercing. Boom, boom, boom. Does take 1 damage for that. I will have Colossus attack for 3, getting rid of this Sentinel here, which does make me happy. I thought I was going to try to figure out a way to get rid of this. Mansion X heals when I'm face down. All right, so let's do this. I'm going to spend these 2 to put Angel into play. Then I'm going to spend one, two, three to put R&D facility into play. Lets me give plus 1 to whoever I want, which seems good. Oh, requires 2 mental. Did I spend 2 mental? Yes, I spent 3 mental, in fact. Sweet. Okay, mental is actually very prevalent in this deck. Plus 1 attack and plus 1 thwart. Okay. So, could get rid of this if I use both of these, but then I wouldn't be able to get rid of the minion that comes in. All right. So we're going to do this to remove 2 threat from this. 1-2. Then, I mean, there's no reason to remove threat from this because it's like permanent. So there's literally, as far as I can tell, no reason to remove threat there. So we're going to have Angel just attack. So 2 damage. Gets a consequential damage himself. Why is Colossus still here? Colossus died. Magneto doesn't count as an ally, but these 2 do. Okay. So again, Angel does 2 damage, 1-2. Okay. I am in a decent spot now. Pretty happy with where I am. All right, I'm gonna draw that. Am I gonna keep Mansion X? Exhausted to heal damage from a mutant or an X-Men character. I feel like I do. I feel like I do. I feel like healing is good here. So I'm just gonna draw 4. I'd love to get my Danger Room Training, that's good. Rapid Response is also good. Magic, also good. Alright, always a lot of stuff I want. Okay, so we're going to add 2 threat here. We're not up to 5 yet, so we don't add 1 here. Sentinel's going to attack me. I'm going to defend again. So I take 2 damage. 1-2. Nothing special happens here, right? Nope. Okay. And then I draw a card. Attached to your identity if a copy of target elimination is not attached to you. Otherwise, this card gains surge. So we do attach it. While you are engaged with a sentinel minion, you cannot change form from hero to alter ego. Action. Exhaust your identity to discard this card. All right. So I can't flip forms if I'm engaged with a sentinel. It's not an issue right now, first of all. But second of all, yeah, I don't know that I care about that. Okay. Do, 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 do. All right. So, could spend a mental after I put her into play to just get rid of a thing. There's that. Okay. So, let's see. It is my turn, and I am going to go ahead and do this. 1-2 to get rid of this. When defeated, the first player searches the encounter deck and discard pile for a sentinel minion and reveals it. I'm going to search here. We had that first sentinel that I don't care much about with Garden Patrol. Let's start there. Then flip this card and put Jubilee into play. Hopefully she helps me. I would assume she's an ally. Yes, an ally. X-Men, -1 victory point. First player controls Jubilee. She does not count against your ally limit. Exhaust Jubilee and spend a lightning resource to deal 2 damage to an enemy. Ah, which is better than her 1 attack or 1 thwart. All right, so you don't want her to die because then she'd go to the victory display in a negative way, is what I'm seeing here. Do I have lightning resources? I do. I could also just put magic in. I got this to heal, which would be good. Rapid response is not the worst thing in the world. It's actually very good. I also have danger training room that I could put on somebody. Could have put it on Wolfsbane, actually, to finish that. That's what I should have done. All right, so I wasn't paying attention because I should have Magneto killing these so he can heal himself. All right, mistakes were made. Lessons were learned. Who do I want to give this Danger Room upgrade to? Well, I also can do 3 damage and 3 damage to an enemy with an upgrade for 2. I'd rather just put allies in. 1-2. And then I gotta spend 1 more somewhere. So I'll put this ricochet beam done to put magic in. Oh, and then I could spend a mental resource to get rid of this. To choose a non-elite. That is definitely not elite. Engage with X-Men hero and shuffle them into the encounter deck. That's what I was planning on doing. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna spend that mental to shuffle them back into the encounter deck. Which is great. Now I'm going to spend this to add +1 to all your stats and make you even better. Yeah. Danger Room training is really good on Wolverine, too. All right. So Wolfsbane would die if I did this, but he's only 2 costs. That's actually fine. He's X-Men. All right. We're just going to do some damage. We'll see where we end up here. So 1 damage here because I can always use her ability later. So it's 1 damage, 3 more damage, and 2 more damage. So it's 5-6 total damage. 1-2-3-4-5-6. And you know what's about to happen. I'm about to have Wolfsbane get rid of him. So, although he's probably going to come in with tough again. So you know what? I'm not going to get rid of him. Now, I do have to increase damage on these 2. So yeah, I did an R&D facility. That's fine. I got a turn. I got time. I'm in no rush. Now I could flip. Yeah, I don't care about flipping. All right, so let's ready up and draw up. And be done. All right, so we got, thanks for the shout out. It says Rich Plays Board Games. I do have a YouTube, but mostly post on Instagram. A bunch of comedy reels about board games, but this isn't about me. I'm just happy to be here for a live playthrough. All right, Rich, that's good to hear. Comedy, huh? On Instagram. See, I'm not, that's like the one social media I'm not on. I'm even on TikTok, but I'm not on Instagram. It's like literally the one I'm not on. But I do like comedy stuff, so I'll have to check you out for sure. Wow, so many allies. Yes, so these three are allies. Magneto was an ally from the campaign mission, so was Jubilee. So yes, and both of them say that they don't count against my ally count or ally limit. So yeah, yeah, we're gonna do it. And I got this: after you recover, heal 3 damage from among characters you control. So that means these count as well, so I could heal them in a minute as well. Do I have my visor yet, please? No, but I have Phoenix and Cerebro, which maybe I don't need looking back on it. Okay, so we're going to add one threat here. Then the Sentinel is going to attack me. Am I going to defend? I am going to defend as usual. Oh, he's been doing +1 damage. So that happened at least twice. So attached to the villain. So I can spend all those mental to discard it. They gain retaliate 1. Yeah, I don't like retaliate. So I could get rid of, honestly, one or the other of these. I did not realize he was doing +1 damage. So I defended. He's not plus attack. So he does have 3 attacks still, though. So I take 1 damage. Yeah, I'm going to have to flip here in a second because I don't want to die. All right. So I could get rid of one or the other of those. Remove 3 threat from a scheme and then get a tactic. Maybe. Isn't there one that, like, nobody takes consequential damage from attacking? +1 damage per attack it takes. That's pretty good. I mean, I might be able to kill him this turn with that, just with that. And then I could bring Phoenix out. And then, all right. So let's see. I may just win the game right here, which is good because I hear my dogs barking upstairs, and that is not good. Okay, so... I do have to take an encounter card. That's the last thing I gotta do, which hinder 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. That would let me get a captive ally, which would be a thing. Okay, I'm just gonna try to win here this turn. I have no idea what's gonna happen when he flips, but I don't really care because I can do about a bazillion damage right now. So he says, after Magneto attacks and defeats a Sentinel. And is he a Sentinel? He sure is. So we will start there. Although, no, because I don't need him. I don't need that extra damage. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put Exploit Weakness out. I'll use Cerebro to do that. To put Exploit Weakness. Now, every attack against him does 1 extra damage, which seems good. So I'm going to start with Magic, attacking, and doing 3 damage, which advances the Sentinel. Yep, I was right. He gets tough. Steady tough. The first player searches the encounter deck and discard pile for a copy of Abduction Protocols and reveals it. Deal each other player a face down encounter card. Well, I'm the first player, so that's great for solo. There are these two. I'd love to start rescuing more of these allies. We'll see how that works. So I'm going to use Wolfsbane Piercing. So 3 attack and piercing. So tough goes away. I don't know where tough went anyway, but it is now gone. 3 damage because of the +1 damage. Okay. I kind of want to rescue... Well, I'm going to play Phoenix, 1, 2. We use tactical. Well, let's see what she does. After Phoenix enters play, choose Cyclops card in your discard pile and add it to your hand. So if I get a 1 cost anything. All right. Yeah, I'll just use this. So I'll search for any card. -1 attack might be the cost. Well, I can do ricochet beam. Yeah. When defeated, I'll just do minus one attack. All right, so I get this minus one attack. Phoenix comes into play. All right, is this an attack also? Yes. So I will play tactical to use my optical blast. So that's four damage, 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll have Angel attack and be defeated. That's three more damage, 1, 2, 3. We will have, oh, this is a lightning. So I'll do this. Action, exhaust Jubilee and spend a lightning to deal two damage to an enemy. I will do that. I will use R&D facility to give Phoenix +1/+1, and she will attack for 3, +1 would be 4, and then we will finish it off here with Magneto, who will defeat it, so he will get his stuff back. And that's that. All right. Oh, I forgot he had +1 anyway, so I would have been doing more damage either way. So that was that. That was fun. All right. So that was a fun scenario. I don't know why this wasn't scenario one. I mean, I get it thematically why it wasn't, but man. Anyway. All right. I'm going to call it a night because I got to go take care of the dogs. But thank you so much for joining me. I will definitely continue this campaign maybe tomorrow night. We'll see if I get some free time. But thanks for joining me. And as always, I appreciate everybody. And hopefully you had fun with this, because I definitely wanted to get through this campaign. And I'm glad that I'm getting a chance to play it. So, yeah, I enjoyed this Sentinel scenario much more than I enjoy the first scenario. So that's good. That makes me happy. Anyway, talk to you soon. Bye.